struggling from the charity stripe here in the first quarter as that one goes in and out.
As they both do, but Antoine Guerrard comes up with that huge wide open rebound.
Sloppy turnover there by the Gaiters. Ball heads in the other direction. Barry Bow trying to set up a play. Pull-up jumper is good. Lumpazier nearly lost it. Still has control of the ball. The shot clock's down to six. Whistle on the plate as Lumpazier is driving hard to the basket. Hunter back into the game for the Gaiters after a bit of a breather.
Team 11 here with a minute and 58 to go in the first quarter. Laval has the 2-point lead over the Gaiters.
Whistle on the play. Looks like Matt McClain's going to get charged for the foul, which is going to send Christian de Royer through the line for Laval. Go here in the first. Whistle on the play underneath the basket.
The Gaiters continue to put the Rougeaux on the line here tonight as they've had they've almost gotten fouled on every possession. Luckily for the Gaiters, the Rougeaux are struggling from the foul line tonight.
Antoine Guillard at the line for the foul, freshman forward, goes 0 for 2, and they're really struggling from the charity stripe. John Lumpazier has really pushed the ball at court every time he's got the ball in his hands tonight. Got fouled on his drive to the basket. It'll send him to the line to shoot, too. He went 0 for 2 a while ago. That streak continues. The score, 74 seconds to play here in the first quarter. Fadeaway turnaround jumper is good. That was a beautiful shot at the end of the rip. Just developed by five, the largest lead they've had this evening. Jeremy Lennon-Smith for three. fouled on the release, and he's going to head to the line. Second time Jeremy Leonard-Smith has been fouled from beyond the arc. Went 2 for 3 on his last trip to the line. For Leonard Smith, but he does hit both to bring the Gaiters within 3. Gary Bow for 3, no good. Gaiters with a 2-on-1 fast break. Mark Brazier off the glass for 2.
Sean Monpazier has had a great first quarter here. You can tell he really wants it tonight. Cutting this lead down to 1 for the Rougeois, 12 seconds. And just like that, the lead goes back to 4.
So the Gaiters can get a shot off here before the end of the quarter. Tim Hunter for 3, no good. That's how the quarter is going to end after 10 minutes of play. It was about 20, Bishop 16. The winner of this game heads to the playoffs. The loser's season is over. So what do you think Rod Gilpin's telling his squad after the first frame?
Well, they're definitely got to continue to look to push the ball, but I feel like I said before, every possession down the floor, Laval's either got a good shot off or a trip to the foul line. So, I mean, they need to stop the hacking. Although Laval isn't shooting their best from the line, it's what's giving them this lead right now. So, if the Gaiters can play good, solid foul-free defense, then they could definitely get back into this. Pretty even statistics along here. Rebounds 12 to 11 for Laval. Points in the paint were tied at 6. Shooting percentage, though, definitely better here from Laval, although Laval hasn't hit many shots from beyond the 3.
Laval also struggling from charity stripe, 4 for 12 from the line. Leading the way for Laval in terms of points. Antoine Guillard off the bench with 7 points. The Gaiters, meanwhile, Jeremy Leonard Smith and Sean Mulfazier each have 6 apiece. Only 1 assist for the Gaiters in the first quarter. Cumberland better do a better job of their ball movement here in the second as they trail by 4.
Laval doing a better job at spreading out the scoring here, where we only have 3 Gaiters on the board at all from the first quarter.
Laval get the ball to start things off here in the second quarter. It's Barry Bow being guarded by Montfrazier. It's in the Breck will add to the Laval lead with an uncontested layup. 22-16 to score now.
Laval sets up in a 2-3 zone. That'll give the Gaiters a different look here. Leonard Smith should have taken that open shot.
Matt McLean with some nice moves from the paint. And then the cute little underhand dish to Leonard Smith puts it in easy 2 points.
Foul called there against Boris Hazmertovic. Looks like Laval will go back into their man.
Hunter rifles a pass inside to Montpensier. Layup attempt no good. Follow-up attempt by McLean no good. Now goes back inside to Hasmer. It's a nice little hook shot for two.
Beautiful spin move there, but didn't really have position after the spin to put the shot up for the angle. Laval has a 6-point lead.
Deep three by the Rougier, no good.
Tim Hunter. Micaiah Post with the beautiful cut to the rim there as he gets the ball from Hunter. 24-20 with 8 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Turnover Laval, beautiful pass from Leonard Smith to Hunter as he gets the left-handed layup again, which brings this game, Laval, to a 2-point lead.
Tim Hunter, after a pretty quiet first quarter by his standards, coming to life here in the second. Kyle was also going to do much in the first frame, but he's got a bucket here in the second quarter. McLean guarding Hasmer. Tovich Hunter with a steal.
That puts the Gaiters up by one, 25-24, with 7:22 left to go.
Not that this crowd was dead by any stretch, but that just brought the crowd to life. A nice run there by the Gaiters. 7 unanswered points. We have a 1-point lead with 7:22 to go in the first half. As you said, in the first quarter, it was really Jeremy Leonard Smith and Sean Montpensier, not really much else, but Tim Hunter and Micaiah Post coming to life here in the second quarter.
For sure, and that's what we need to see, is all players contributing both offensively and defensively here for the Gaiters. And as we saw, they did. They took the lead.
Early on, but the Gaiters have also done a better job of avoiding fouls here in the second quarter. Again, the math is pretty simple. If Bishops wins this game, they're in the playoffs. If they lose, they're out, and Laval is in. This is a Bishops team that started conference playoff with an 0-7 record. They really come to life here since the Christmas break. Laval, meanwhile, a team that I think a lot of people expected to contend for maybe the top spot in the conference. And they've had a relatively disappointing season up to this point, but they can, to a certain extent, redeem themselves here tonight and at least clinch a playoff spot as the ball goes out of bounds.
14 seconds left on the shot clock. Laval's ball movement there, very nice as they get that shot. Matt McLean with the big rebound.
Quick pass to Micaiah Post. It was off the glass. Talk about the Gators' surge in the second half. A big reason for that's been Micaiah Post. He's really come on strong here. Second half.
Post couldn't get the layup to drop. Scott Ring putting good pressure on the ball here.
Three-pointer thrown out there by Hughes. Ryan is good.
Jeremy Leonard Smith will try his three out. Fortunately, that went in and bounced out.
Gaiters lead by one, 5.5 to go here in the second quarter. Hatsmeritovic dribbling just outside the paint, and there's a whistle on the play. Sean Alpazir, Mike Andrews, and Rudo Fasero into the game for the still Laval ball, however. Campbell on an inbound on the baseline. Laval's three-pointer is air ball. Zero found a crease, drove to the basket, and got fouled.
Number 10, Thibaut DeZetter, not very happy with that call. From my angle, he did look like he had position, but Sean Montplaisir will shoot two. Both his free throws to tie the game up at 29 apiece with 5:03 to go here in the second quarter.
Freshman Mitchell Pierman into the game for the Gaiters. Guy who didn't get much playing time early on in the season, but we've seen quite a bit more of him recently. Past the halfway point of the second quarter, we're all tied up at 29 apiece. With that 31-29 Laval.
Rudolf Aristal will go for three. That's no good.
I was going to get a whistle for a backcourt violation. Kemo handed the ball off. Of course, into the backcourt. He's not happy about that call, but it's going to be Gator's ball. Timeout call by Rod Gilp from the 4:22 to go in the quarter. The Gators trailed by two, 31-29 to score. Season on hand here tonight for the regular season finale. This will be the last men's game of the season. Depending on how things shake out in the playoffs, it's always possible that the women could host the Quebec Conference Finals. It's 31-29. They're actually shooting 50% from the field, 12-24 thus far. The only lead, obviously, by two. Leading scorer for the Rouge et is Antoine Guillard with 9. Jeremy Leonard-Smith and Sean Montpazier have 8 apiece. For the Gaiters, while Makai Post has chipped in with 7.
Great layout attempt there from Sean Montpazier. He couldn't get that to fall, but he'll go to the line and shoot too.
Sean Montpazier has been incredibly aggressive here in the first half for the Gaiters.
He misses his first attempt from the free throw. Makes his second, which brings the Laval lead down to 1.
Long three-pointer thrown up there by Laval. Increases the reserve lead to 4. Onik Blackwood, Tim Hunter set to check in for the Gaiters at the next stoppage of play. So Makaya Post drives, goes off the glass, and gets the ball. Another 3-point attempt by the Ruggiero. That one no good. Rebound grab by Mike Andrews. Gaiters go quickly in the other direction. Gaiters answer with a 3 of their own. Rudolph Iris still. 36-35 now the score. Laval nearly lost control of the ball there, but they'll retain possession. Shot clock down to 11. Bizarre pull-up jumper, no, it was close to being good. Loose ball grabbed by Mike Andrews. Gaiters with a chance to take the lead. It's post for 3. No good. A lot of contact under the basket and no whistle. A lot of contact on the other end as well, but that one is going to draw a foul.
Subs in on both sides.
That's the line for Laval, number 12. It's the end of the heck. He's had himself a nice first half. Adds to his point tally there, sinks his first shot.
Beautiful pass from Hunter to Montpazier.
No whistle on the play. Gaiters drop the rebound on it to Blackwood. Slow things down to give it to Tim Hunter. We're under 2 minutes to go. Both teams playing pretty good basketball right now.
Blackwood with the little jumper, no good.
Barrybo with a head of steam, tries to go high off the glass, no good, but the follow-up is good. Yes. 40-37, both teams have come to life here in the second. 80 seconds to go, on its Blackwood has the ball for BU. Shot clock down to 9. Smith heading to the line for the Gaiters. Chance to make this a one-point game yet again. He hits his first shot. Now the score. Terry Bow with a deep three in and out, ball still loose. Hunter Smith grabs the rebound.
Seconds left on the game clock. Laval has the one-point lead.
15-second gap between the shot clock and the game clock. No whistle on the play. Still Gator's ball. Tim Hunter's going to get fouled after grabbing the glass.
And the Gators are in bonus, so he will shoot two.
So Tim Hunter's going to head to the line with a chance to give, to tie this game up, possibly give the Gators the lead.
Tim Hunter misses his first one.
Hunter uncharacteristically goes 0 for 2, but the Gators do get the ball back and a chance to take the last shot of the half. Lefrazier is holding it near midcourt, being guarded by Beribeau. He's going to drive himself and draw the whistle.
Sean Monplaisir misses his first. Hits his second. The game is tied 40-40.
Laval has a chance to take the last shot, and Barry Day's going to drive uncontested. See if the Gators can get one off before the buzzer. They can't. And that's how things are going to end. So a late Laval layup is the difference after 20 minutes of play. 42-40 the score. Very impressive first half of basketball between two teams battling for the final playoff spot in the queue. You're watching Gators basketball here on SSN Canada. We're going to take a 3-minute break. We'll be back with you for the second half. And we are back, and as you can tell from the noise here, from the crowd, this is a big game. 42-40 is the score after 20 minutes of play. As we mentioned ad nauseum, for both teams, do or die, win and you're in, lose and your season is done. Good first half of basketball. The Gators looking for the doubleheader sweep of Laval here at home on senior night at Mitchell Gymnasium. Early foul sends Mike Andrews to the line with a chance to tie this game up, which won't happen as he misses his first free throw attempt.
Misses both, and free throws have really been something that's been lacking on both ends here tonight, which could definitely hurt them in the fourth quarter.
Nice inside pass and an easy 2 points for Laval as they extend their lead to four. There's a bucket of the second half. Post field goal attempt, no good, but Laval bobbles the ball heading up court. Sloppy turnover by Hughes Ryan, who's trying to plead his case to his head coach, although it doesn't seem to be going over well. Wasn't ready for the pass, bounced off his hands and out of bounds.
Jeremy Leonard Smith to Micaiah Post. Post will get that layup.
DZT with a layup attempt, no good. Laval coaching staff wanted a foul, they're not going to get it, and the Gators are going in the other direction. Post pump fakes, drives baseline, can't get the shot to fall. Two-point attempt by Dizzy T, no good.
Montplaisir with the ball at the top. Leonard Smith. Out to Hunter for three, no good. Rebound Post. Beautiful pass to Jeremy Leonard Smith.
Great ball movement there by the Gators. They're all tied up at 44 apiece. A couple of really nice passes by the Gators on that last possession as Laval defenders are out of position. Seven and a half to go in the third. Shot clock is down to six for Laval. Billy Bowe is going to throw up a long three. No good.
The ball goes off of Boris. It'll be a Gators ball. Sean Montplaisir takes the ball up the court.
Xavier Billy Bowe is usually a bit of a Gators killer. He's been pretty quiet by his standards tonight as Montplaisir drives to the basket. Tries to dish it to Hunter, goes out of bounds, but Laval touched the glass.
Mike Andrews with his jumper, that's no good. Montplaisir is called for a push. We're all tied up 44-44 with 7:06 to go.
You're not going to see Mike Andrews take that shot too often, though he's got pretty good range for a 6-foot-10 center.
Yeah.
Matthews. Ryan with a pull-up jumper, no good. Ends up with the ball back in his hands, although he loses it. Mads Hamill for the loose ball after the missed field goal attempt. Jumper by Onyx Blackwood, no good. He's been very quiet tonight.
Blackwood being almost invisible here tonight.
Maryville lost the ball on his way up court, but the Gaiters touched it last. It's still Laval ball with 13 on the shot clock.
9 seconds on the shot clock.
That's Maritovich. Fell for the old shot clock by the crowd, but it was all for naught as he gets the shot to fall. Hunter with a wide open three, no good off the back of the rim. Rebound grab by Hasmertovich. Quick outlet pass in the other direction. Layup attempt is good. Use Ryan off the glass. Laval up by four, 48-44 the score.
Jeremy Leonard Smith with the nice spin.
Leonard Smith is fouled on the inbound pass. Peters get the ball right back. The crowd is going crazy. Into it as the Gaiters have a chance to tie this up. 48-all, 5:28 to go. Possibly even take the lead. Three-pointer thrown up, no good. Mike Andrews grabs the rebound but can't save it in time. Kicking it out, three-pointer by Dizutsu, no good.
Foul call to Simon Mercier over the back there.
Past the halfway point of the third quarter, the Gaiters trail by two just as they did at the half.
Mitchell Pierman with an air ball.
Up by four, Scott Rinn nearly lost him, but corralled the ball in time. Kaya post underneath the basket off the glass, no good. Matt McClain will be checking in shortly for the Gaiters. Xavier Beribo kicks one out to Boris Hadzimatovic. No good.
Nice pass from the post to Mike Andrews.
Both teams are really moving the ball pretty well right now after a bit of a choppy first quarter. Both teams seem to have found their rhythm, a relatively high scoring game. Obviously very close, 2-point game. Both teams want this one. That should go without saying.
Gators forced a turnover. Scott Randall to keep out the pass, but wide open behind a post. Looks like he thought about throwing it down. Thought better, went off the glass, and we're all tied up. .315 to go. Bishop's 50, Laval 50.
Rod Gilpin's going to go with the hockey change there. Five fresh legs on the court for the Gators. It's McLean, Montpazier, Blackwood, Leonard, Smith, and Hunter all into the game for BU.
Sloppy turnover there by Laval. Bulls back for Kovic. Couldn't handle the pass. Bounced off the net and out of bounds.
Montpazier with the ball at the top. He goes inside to Matt McLean. Matt McLean is fouled down low.
Interesting strategy by Rod Gilpin as he goes five in, five out.
For sure. I think Coach Gilpin is going with the fresh legs here. Usually you go with the players that are working well. So we'll see how this five-player switch goes. Beautiful pass inside from Matt McLean as he went into Montpazier. Montpazier will go to the line and shoot two, and we'll see how he does with his free throw attempts, as both teams have been struggling from the line tonight. He hits his first one. That puts the Gators up by one. The crowd into this game definitely backing their Bishop's Gators here tonight. He goes 2 for 2, which puts the Gators up by two. 52-50 with 2:50 left to go here in the third quarter. Gerhard. Good defense here by the Gators, taking the shot clock down to 8. Jeremy Leonard Smith with the steal. He'll go to Blackwood.
3-on-1 for the Gators.
Blackwood, and the crowd is on their feet here as the Rouge Aurore call a timeout, a much-needed timeout. As the Gators lead 54-50 with 2:25 to go, this crowd is probably the best I've seen it yet this year here in the Mitchell Gymnasium, as they are heated up for their home crowd.
Chuck came on scene enough, calls a timeout for Laval, and almost sprinted to make court and stole Antoine Guillard, who got stripped on that last possession. Momentum tilting on the side of the Gators right now as they lead by 4. It's hard to believe watching this game that these are, standings-wise, at least the two worst teams in the community. It's kind of a dead basketball game, but the Gators, as we said, got off to a slow start, but they've really found their rhythm here after Christmas. Laval, meanwhile, it's been a bit of a disappointing season, but we all know that they're talented. And both teams have brought their A game here tonight for the most part.
The Gators are showing some slight pressure here from Montpazier, not making it easy for the Rouge Aurore. Etienne Lebrecq with the three that cuts the Gators' lead to 1. T. Tim Hunter for three from the corner. Big rebound there by Boris Hadzimatovic as he carries the ball off the court. Another three from Etienne LeBrec. That puts Laval up by two here.
And the Rouge are dangerous when they start hitting those shots from the three. Saw that last time they were here. Onyx Blackwood's going to try and drive baseline. And boom, goes the diamond.
And it's a tied game here again with 1:18 left to go in the third quarter.
Another three-pointer thrown up by Laval. That one's good. And we have seen this out of the Rouge and Arrow before. When they start getting confident from beyond the arc, they can be very impressive. They are on fire right now. Three straight trips up the court. Three straight no-doubter.
And that's something the Gators defense needs to know here in this close of a game. You can't give them the open shots that they want as Onyx Blackwood slips and loses the ball. Matt McLean has called for the intentional foul there. So, again, not a calls that Coach Copen really wants to see. I mean, they're going to get the free throws and the ball back. And at this point in the game, it's tough.
Hadzimatovic is kind of wrenched his back or something. I don't know if he's milking after a little more than his work, but he's going to head to the sideline. 59-56 to score.
I mean, every possession at this point in the game is crucial. To give them the shots plus a second possession is, I'm not going to say a rookie mistake because he's in second year, but like that's not a mentally smart move to do this late in the basketball game when you trail by three. So the Rouge Or will shoot two when they come back to try and extend their lead here to five and make it a two-possession ball game.
A little bit of a cushion that the Gators had has obviously disappeared as Laval has caught fire from beyond the arc. The timeout winds down. Six-foot-9, Boris Hadzimatovic, freshman center, heads to the line to shoot through. Looks like he might have creeped something on that intentional foul by McLean.
The crowd really trying to get to him, but it doesn't as he makes that first free throw. Misses his second. He's subbed out by number 14, Simon Mercier. And like we said, with the intentional foul, Laval will get possession of the ball back.
Gaiters inbounds it near midcourt. 6-point game, under a minute to go in the third. LeBrec for two, and it's good. Laval, just like that, has opened up an 8-point lead.
Six.
6-point lead. Math is never mind.
Tim Hunter to Leonard Smith.
A sloppy turnover there by Leonard Smith. Just a brutal giveaway there by the Gators. Three-pointer by LeBrec, no good. Ball goes out of bounds. That's how the third quarter is going to end. So an impressive run there by the Rouge AR in the dying minutes of the third. 30 minutes down, 10 minutes to go in regulation. The score is 62-56 in favor of the visiting squad.
The turnover there by Leonard Smith, although Laval didn't score in return to that. I mean, that also means with that turnover that the Gaiters didn't score there either. And like we said, each possession at this point in the game is crucial, and you have to use each possession like it's your last. So, like, mental mistakes, like we've said from the beginning, it's obvious the talent is there on both sides. When it comes down to it, in these type of situations, it all comes down to the mental aspect. And really, we've seen the close game, like the close scoring throughout the entire game. I think this fourth quarter will come down to who can be more mentally tough.
Yeah, I'm not sure if the Gators got a little overconfident there, if Laval just started to catch fire. But in any case, the Gators lead disappearing pretty quickly there, as Laval looked really, really impressive in the dying minutes of the third quarter. They were really firing on all cylinders. Both teams shooting the ball relatively well, about 48% from the field, the Gators 40% from the field. Like you said, both teams really struggling from a charity stripe, though. Laval is sub 50%. They're only 7 for 16. Gators not doing a whole lot better. They're 14 for 23 on the night. Leading scorer for Laval, it's the end of the heck with 15 points. For the Gators, it's really been a three-headed monster. Jeremy Leonard, Smith, Sean Montpezier with 14 apiece. Micaiah Post just behind them with 13 of his own. Stats really jumping out off the page. Teams relatively even in terms of rebounds, turnovers, blocks, points in the paint.
Foul called there to number 8, Jeremy Leonard Smith. Questionable call at best.
Reffing crew telling Rod Gilpin to settle down on the sidelines. He wasn't happy with that one, and I can't blame him. Carr didn't like it either, but it is a Laval ball. It's in the wreck. Smith still has the ball, ends up driving, going for the reverse knee up.
Etienne LeBrec really heating up here in this second half. Had an excellent third quarter.
Blackwood outside the arc right now, holding it. Shot clock down to 9.
Beautiful pass from Montpezier into Blackwood. That makes this a 6-point game with 9 minutes to go.
The Gators really needed that. Some sort of bucket, some sort of play to stop the bleeding a little bit.
The Gators can't buy a call here in the fourth quarter. Every possession, but like we said, almost every possession of the entire game, the Gaiters have bailed Laval out in some way, giving them an opportunity to go to the foul line.
Desertier hits his first shot. 58 to score, 9 minutes to go. Second free throw attempt, no good. Mike Andrews controls the rebound, and it's Gators' ball. Shot clock already down to 9 for BU. Blackwood pump fakes and pulls up from the baseline, no good. Mike Andrews gets the offensive board. Scored it out of bounds, but Laval touched it last. So
Rene Pierre Mathieu checks in for the Rougeor as well as Tim Hunter for the Gaiters.
Onyx Blackwood going to head to the bench for BU. Hunter inbound the ball near the Gators bench, 17 seconds on the shot clock.
Beautiful lob pass there from Tim Hunter.
Hunter is so good at that, whether it's from the baseline or sort of from the top of the three-point circle. He's really good at lobbing those touch passes in there. Weird shot by the Rougeor, goes off the side of the backboard.
Montplaisir showing his hustle and how much he wants this game. Diving loose on the floor. Leonard Smith cuts this lead to 365-62. Laval with 7:50 to go here in the fourth. This is a do or die for both teams. Whoever wins moves on. Whoever loses is out.
LeBrec off the screen, pulls up outside the paint. No good. Montplaisir with the rebound. He is having a heck of a game tonight.
Post off the glass for two. The Gaiters are within one.
65-64 for the Rougeor. 7:20 to go. The Gaiters can get a stop here. They could take the lead. And they do.
Gorgeous pass by Montplaisir. Leonard Smith is fouled on his way to the bucket.
Leonard Smith is fouled by Hughes Ryan. He will go to the line as Laval is checking in their two main men, number 5, Xavier Bureau, and number 11, Boris Hadamaturovic.
Jeremy Leonard Smith's going to head to the line for the Gaiters, chance to tie this up and possibly give the Gaiters the lead. And give Bishops credit. Obviously, they weren't going to let this game slip away from them, but Laval was looking real good there at the end of the third and in the opening parts of the fourth, but the Gaiters have clearly clawed their way back into this one, and they trail by one. They don't trail at all. We're all fired up at 65 apiece.
Leonard Smith goes 1 for 2 to tie the game at 65 apiece, 7 minutes to go here.